Let's get up and running with Strapi in 3 minutes. We'll need to create our Strapi project with the following command. npx create -strapi-app my-project --quickstart. Using the quickstart flag is a great way to get up and running quickly by allowing the project creation process to select some default configuration settings. This will create files in the directory in which it was executed, and because we've used the quickstart flag, our project will be configured to use a SQLite database. Once created, our project will launch in development mode. Before we continue to the Strapi admin panel, we need to create our first user, the root admin. In Strapi, we first need to create the data structure of the content that we want to manage. The content types builder, which we can access in the left navigation, is one way in which we can build them. Let's say we want to create a catalog of restaurants. Time to create our first collection type. We'll call it restaurant. Let's add some fields to store the name, description, and pictures. Let's create another collection type named category. Add a field name and a many-to-many relationship with restaurants. Let's demonstrate the components feature. We'll create a gallery with the fields title and multiple pictures. We'll also create a text block with the text fields title and content. Let's create a single type and we'll name it homepage. Let's add a field named title and a dynamic zone named body that will make use of our previously created components to add a text block and a gallery. With our structures created, let's enter the content manager and contribute some content to our application. First, we'll add a couple of categories. Next, we'll add a restaurant complete with a description, pictures that we upload, and select a category to which it belongs. Finally, we'll add a homepage complete with a gallery and a content block. With our content created, let's visit /restaurant where we'll see an HTTP 403 forbidden error. This is because Strapi protects our API endpoints by default. So let's adjust our rows and permissions by opening up a few of the public actions for our restaurant and homepage types. If we refresh the page, we can now see that we have access to our restaurant data. The same is true for our homepage data at /homepage. If we want to populate the components, we need to add %populate=body to the end of our request. That's it for getting up and running with Strapi in 3 minutes.